Hey guys, what's going on? It's iTouch Stuff here, that's spelled with a zero. Finally getting around to an iOS 4.3 jailbreak for you guys today. I'm going to be demonstrating this with the iPod Touch 4G. You can go down below to the description for a list of supported models for this jailbreak. This jailbreak is a tethered jailbreak, so that means every time you turn off your device, you will have to run a software on your computer called iBooty. This is only for Windows, so all Mac users, you will need Pwnage Tool, although Pwnage Tool has not working for me yet, so that's why I'm coming to Windows for this tutorial. So, to start off, head down below to the description below, and you'll find a few download links. One is a redirection to Redmond Pi, which will be a bunch of other links for your specific model to download the IPSW for your device. Once you've done that, you want to go into iTunes, hit the Shift key on Windows, click the Restore button, and then browse for that IPSW file and restore to it so that you're on the official iOS 4.3. Next, you want to head down below to the description and download Sn0wbreeze 2.3b4. It'll be a zip file, and you basically unzip it, and you get this file right here. So, once you've done all those things, you also want to make sure that you're on iTunes 10.2.1. You can do that very easily by going to iTunes and clicking the Check for Updates button at one of the menus at the top. Very simple. Just make sure you're on that 10.2.1, and then we're good to go. So make sure your iPod or iDevice that is supported is plugged in via USB. I have this really ghetto-style Lego stand because I was getting tired of filming my videos with my camera sort of angled down. So I made a stand in my spare time. So moving on, you can go ahead, after you've made sure that it's plugged in, open up Sn0wbreeze by double-clicking on it. It'll open up. It says this software is for commercial use. Basically, if you bought this from someone, demand a refund immediately because it's not for sale. This is free software on the internet. You should not be paying for it. And then just click the OK button. Click Close Credits, and then click the Next button. Click Yes, and then you basically just find your IPSW file that you just restored to. Drag it right onto that gray box. It's going to identify your IPSW file. It should take a few seconds or so, and then we can move on. Okay, so it's verified my iPod Touch 4G. It says my 4.3 IPSW is verified, and then we can click the next arrow to continue. So then we click on Expert Mode, we click Next, we click Build IPSW, we click Next, and then you can either have an option of playing Pac-Man here, which it does not work for me, so I'm going to return to the spinner, and then you can also go to just stay here and watch the spinner. Wait for it to finish. Okay, so once Sn0wbreeze has finished building your IPSW and everything is swell, you can go ahead and press the OK button to put your device into a Pwn DFU mode. So you can see here it says, please turn off your device. I'm going to switch over to my device, and we're just going to go ahead and turn this thing off simply by holding the power button, if I can get this back here, and sliding to power off, just like the diagram tells us to, as you can see over here. So I'm going to zoom out a little bit, focus in, and now that our device is off, we can go ahead and click the start button. So now press the home and power for 5 seconds. Release the power button. And it's nice that Sn0wbreeze does give a little extra time at the beginning, a 5 second head start. I'm going to click yes on my screen. Keep holding. And here we go, it's running iRev, exploiting with Lime Rain, doing a bunch of cool stuff. We are now in a Pwn DFU mode state, black screen. You may now launch iTunes and begin the software restore. So that's all good, we can go ahead and click the OK button. And it's just going to clean up. And we can go ahead and exit out of Sn0wbreeze. Alright guys, so after everything is done, you will see a new folder on your desktop called iBooty for 4.3. And for some reason, it's not showing on my desktop. So if it doesn't for you, just go to the desktop directory in your Finder. And then you should also see your hacked IPSW, which mine is Sn0wbreeze iPod Touch 4-4.3. And this is what we will be updating to. So now you can go ahead and open up iTunes like I have already, very simply. And then let's zoom in. Do the same thing that you did before. Click the Shift key. Click the Restore button. Also make sure that your iPod is connected via USB. And then you want to browse for your file. So mine is on my desktop, Sn0wbreeze, open, restore, and we can see up here extracting software. Okay, so everything is all done. I'm very lucky that I made it through all of the errors. I actually encountered a 1600 error this time around, but I ended up fixing it. You just have to go ahead and download another iReb version and just use that again. But you probably won't need to use that because just my iPod is the only one that's messed up around here. I've had so many errors, but I guess the iReb from Sn0wbreeze 2.3 itself didn't work out, so I had to use iReb again. But it's finally all done, and it's asking me to restore from a backup now since this is on iTunes, and my last backup was on 10/10/2010. I'm not going to restore to that, so I'm going to quit out of iTunes for now and cancel this sync. And we can go over to my iPod, which you should now have Cydia on if you have followed through this process. So, over here, Cydia is right up there in all of its glory. But you will notice when you click on it, boom, crash. So this is where iBooty comes in hand. Basically, again, iBooty is the application you'll have to run every time you turn your device off. And this is also the application that we have to run the first time we have to open up Cydia. So I'm going to go to my desktop here. And this is where my iBooty is right here. And you want to click on iBooty. Make sure your device is plugged in via USB. It's going to open up iBooty version 2.0. Select your iDevice. I have the iPod Touch 4G or 4 right here. Click and let's start. So, searching for DFU, prepare to press and hold the home. Hold it for 10 seconds. Release the power button. Hopefully I can focus now. And basically this is what you have to do every time you turn your device off. So if you do question why when you turn it on, after you've turned it off, why it's not booting up, this is what you have to do to get it to boot up. And that's the whole meaning of tethered, unfortunately. Okay, so we're all booted up here nice and well. And iBooty has worked, and now we can go ahead and launch up Cydia for the first time. You can see it actually works now. I'm going to connect to my Wi-Fi network, initializing file system, and Cydia will exit when complete. So guys, if you followed through this whole tutorial and it worked out for you guys in the end, Cydia is now working and it's going through this process. Please give this video a thumbs up down below, make sure to subscribe. This has been iTouch Stuff here, that's spelled with a 0, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.